do you know that you cannot take a screenshot of your browser when it is in incognito mode? And there are several other issues which you can fix by making some small changes in the setting without using third-party app. And to fix all such kind of issues, I have started a new series, How to Do It in Your Mobile Phone. Hope you guys will love this series. And if you are interested in a particular setting, you can use the timestamp for that. But I will request you to watch entire video, which will help me to gain more subscriber and view time. So on that note, let's start the video. Web browsers does not allow users to take screenshot in incognito mode on Android smartphone for privacy reasons. But if you want to remove this restriction, you can easily do so. To allow a screenshot for incognito tabs, we will have to alter this setting by using flags for all Chromium based browser. And here are the steps you need to follow. Open the web browser on your Android smartphone. For example, here I am using Chrome browser, as it is the most common browser used by everyone. You can also use Brave browser and follow the same steps. Now in the address bar, type browser name followed by colon and then double slash and then type flags and enter. Now in the search bar at the top of the page, look for screenshots and from the search result, go to the incognito screenshot option and from the drop down, select enable. You will be now requested to relaunch the Chrome app on your device for the changes to take effect. Tap on the relaunch at the bottom and the app will reopen. You will be now able to take a screenshot even in the incognito mode. Now for any other browser which is not based on Chromium like Firefox, you just have to go to setting, select private browsing and enable allow screenshot in private browsing. That's all. You are ready to take screenshots. One thing which you always tend to forget is your Wi-Fi password. So when your friend visits your place, you need to follow one of the most difficult questions. What is the password of your Wi-Fi? Now to avoid such situations, you just need to follow these steps. Go to the setting app and head towards Wi-Fi and network. Or you can directly long press the Wi-Fi icon which is available in notification panel. Next is, once you enter Wi-Fi setting, towards the top you will find the connected Wi-Fi network and when you scroll down, you will also have the saved Wi-Fi networks which you have previously used and their password is already saved. Now if you want to share or view the Wi-Fi password of connected or saved network, just click on the respective network of your choice and then towards the right hand side, you can see share with QR code icon on it. Now when you click on share, your phone will request you to authenticate your phone. Once you authenticate, you will see the QR code which help you to share the network and below the QR code, you will find the password. Now you can easily share your network as well as password without having any load of remember or write it down for future reference. Google Assistant has become an integral part of everyday's life and you can use it in any situation and it continues to learn new skills. It can schedule your task, play your favorite music and even answer any weird question you might have. However, it also have the peculiar habit of popping up from time to time for no reason. And to solve this, your best option is to shut down it completely. Here's how you can turn it off completely. Go to the Google app on your phone and tap More button which is on the left side bottom. And then select Setting. Tap on Google Assistant tab and scroll down to General section. Now the first option in the screen is to enable or disable Google Assistant. Now click here to disable Google Assistant. It will give you a warning message related to turning it off. Click on Turn Off and you are done. And of course, if you want to turn your assistant back to normal, you just have to toggle it right. That's all. Google Assistant evolved a lot from the time it launched first time. Now we have support of different voice and different regional and international languages as well. Now if you are interested to change any one of them, you just need to follow these steps. Open the Google app on your Android phone and tap on More at the bottom right corner. On the next page, tap on Setting and select Google Assistant. Here, scroll down to find out Assistant Voice option. Tap on it. Now you can change the voice of Google Assistant. Google uses different color to denote assistant voice. There are two options available in my device, including red and orange. Slide on circle to choose the voice option and select your preferred one. Now just like voice, you can also change the language of Google Assistant. Navigate to Google app and tap More and then tap on Setting. Here tap on Google Assistant and scroll down till you find the languages. To change the primary language, tap on first option, or to add second language, tap on the add language option and choose your language from the list. Most of the time we use third-party app to create parallel or dual app in our Android phone. But you can create dual app without using these third-party app. And here are the steps you should follow as per your mobile phone manufacturer. Now this option has different placeholder, depends on manufacturer. So first let's check out for OnePlus. So in OnePlus, it reflect as parallel apps. Now you go to setting app and then utility. Under this you will find parallel app. Tap on it and you will find the list of all the apps which you can duplicate in your phone. In Redmi, or you can say in MIUI, it is known as dual app. So for MI or Redmi phones, go to the setting and then under apps, the third option is dual app. Now you can create your dual app from here. For other manufacturers like Samsung, it is known as dual messenger. You can go to the setting and under advanced feature, you will find dual messenger. In Oppo and Vivo, it is known as clone apps. And under setting, you will find clone apps. Asus comes with twins app. Under the setting, you will find twin apps. And Huawei or Honor have app twin. Under setting, you will find app twin. Now you can use these options to create dual app in your mobile phone. So that was the first episode of how to do it in your mobile phone. If you have any query, do let me know in the comment section. I will try to add in my next video. Give a thumbs up if you enjoyed this video. Share with your friends and you do not forget to subscribe our channel for more amazing tech videos. Thanks for watching.